Good morning students, welcome to science class. Today we are going to see term 2, first lesson, heat and temperature, part 1. So listen carefully students, make a note of important points. If you are having any doubt, note the question in notebook and it will be clarified on the day of reopening. Students, today we are going to learn about temperature and its units, measuring temperature, thermometer and types of thermometers. So above these topics covered into book page number 1 to 5. Okay, let's start the lesson. Students, I hope last year you have learned about heat. Sun, combustion, electricity, friction are the sources of heat. Let's see some examples. We are feeling shivering when it is cold and sweat when outside is hot. How can we feel temperature? Temperature is involved in many aspects of our daily lives. Already I said, we are able to feel temperature from cooking, sweating and weather conditions. So what is temperature? The measurement of warmness or coldness of a substance is known as its temperature. The measurement of warmness or coldness of a substance is known as its temperature. Temperature is a measure of the average kinetic energy of the particles in an object. Temperature is related to how fast the atoms within a substance are moving. See the picture. Movements are less at low temperature. If you are raising the temperature, particles' movements has been faster. So temperature is related to how fast the atoms within a substance are moving. Now, we are going to study about temperature units. There are three units used to measure temperature. First one degree Celsius, second one Fahrenheit and third one Kelvin. Let's see briefly. First one degree Celsius. Celsius is written as degree Celsius, that is circle with the capital C, and read as degree. For example, see here, this is 20 degree Celsius. Also, Celsius is called as centigrade. Second one, Fahrenheit. Fahrenheit is written as degree Fahrenheit. For example, this is 25 degree Fahrenheit. If the temperature denoted like this means, we can read 25 degree Fahrenheit. Third one, Kelvin. Kelvin is written as capital K. For example, this is 100 Kelvin. It is read as 100 Kelvin. The SI unit of temperature is Kelvin. SI unit of temperature is Kelvin. Now, we will learn about measuring temperature. As we all know, temperature measures the average kinetic energy of molecules. Temperature measures the average kinetic energy of molecules. At lower temperature, movement of particles in a substance are slow. At low temperature, movement of particles in a substance are low. At higher temperature, movement of particles in a molecule are fast. At higher temperature, movement of particles in a molecule are faster. Last year, you have studied thermal expansion. Let's see the example. Before heating, ball goes into ring. See the first diagram. Before heating, ball goes into the ring. But after heating, ball does not go into the ring. Because of heat, ball expands in its size. Because of heat, ball expands in its size. From this, we will learn solids expand on heating. Solids expand on heating. In a thermometer, when liquid gets heat, it expands, and when it is cooled down, it contracts. It is used to measure temperature. Thermometer used to measure temperature. Let's see the activity. Take water in a beaker and heating it by candle or burner. Using scale, note down the position of surface of water and measure the temperature by thermometer. After some time, water gets cooled down and note down the position of water surface. Measure the temperature. What is the change in surface of water on heating and cooling? Listen, students. What is the change in surface of water in heating and cooling? Yes, on heating, the water level is high. On heating, the water level is high. And the water level is low on cooling. Water level is low on cooling. So, when a liquid is heated, it expands. And when it is cooled down, it contracts. We will confirm from this activity, liquid expands on heating and contracts on cooling. Let's see the expansion of a gas. Like solid and liquid, gas also expands on heating and contracts on cooling. Take water in a beaker and keep balloon on its mouth. Now heat the beaker using candle or burner. Temperature rises, water boils and air gets heated, so balloon expands like this. Now you are cooled down the beaker, balloon coming back to the initial stage because it contracts. So gases expands on heating and contracts on cooling. Tell me, students, what is thermometer? Thermometer is the most common instrument to measure temperature. Thermometer is the most common instrument to measure temperature. There are various kinds of thermometers we are used. Clinical thermometer, laboratory thermometer, digital thermometer. There are various kinds of thermometers we are used in our daily life. Why mercury or alcohol is used in thermometer? See, this is alcohol thermometer. This is mercury thermometer. Our question is, why mercury or alcohol is used in thermometer? Let's see the answer. Mostly, alcohol and mercury are used in thermometers as they remain in liquid form even with a change of temperature in them. Mostly, alcohol and mercury are used in thermometers as they remain in liquid form even with a change of temperature in them. A small change in the temperature causes change in volume of a liquid. Listen, students. A small change in the temperature causes change in volume of a liquid. We measure this temperature by measuring expansion of a liquid in thermometer. We measure this temperature by measuring expansion of a liquid in thermometer. Now we will see why specifically mercury and alcohol thermometers are used. First, shall we see properties of mercury. Mercury expansion is uniform. For equal amounts of heat, it expands by equal lengths. So, mercury expansion is uniform. Mercury is opaque and shining. Mercury is opaque and shining. It does not stick to the sides of the glass tube. mercury does not stick to the sides of the glass tube. It is a good conductor of heat. It is a good conductor of heat. It has a high boiling point, that is 357 degrees Celsius, and a low freezing point, that is minus 39 degrees Celsius. Hence, a wide range of temperatures can be measured using a mercury thermometer. Wide range of temperatures can be measured using a mercury thermometer. Second one, we'll see properties of alcohol. The freezing point of alcohol is less than minus 100 degrees Celsius. So it can be used to measure very low temperatures. The freezing point of alcohol is less than minus 100 degrees Celsius. So it can be used to measure very low temperatures. Its expansion per degree Celsius rise in temperature is very large. Alcohol expansion per degree Celsius rise in temperature is very large. Alcohol can be colored brightly and hence is easily visible. It can be colored brightly and hence is easily visible. Now, we are going to study about types of thermometers. Generally, we are seeing thermometer in labs or hospitals. So, commonly used thermometers are clinical thermometer and laboratory thermometer. We will see one by one. First one is clinical thermometer. These thermometers are used to measure the temperature of a human body at home, clinics and hospitals. Clinical thermometers are used to measure the temperature of a human body at home, clinics and hospitals. All clinical thermometers have a kink that prevents the mercury from flowing back into the bulb when the thermometer is taken out of the patient's mouth so that the temperature can be noted conveniently. See, this is bulb, that is mercury bulb. Above the mercury bulb, this is kink. Above the mercury bulb, this is kink. So, a kink that prevents the mercury from flowing back into the bulb when the thermometer is taken out of the patient's mouth, so that the temperature can be noted conveniently. There are temperature scales on either side of the mercury thread, one in Celsius scale and the other in Fahrenheit scale. See the picture. Above scale is Celsius scale. Below scale is Fahrenheit scale. Since the Fahrenheit scale is more sensitive than the Celsius scale, body temperature is measured in Fahrenheit only. Listen, students, body temperature is measured in Fahrenheit only. A clinical thermometer indicates temperatures from a minimum of 35 degrees centigrade or 94 degrees Fahrenheit to a maximum of 42 degrees Celsius or 108 degrees Fahrenheit. A clinical thermometer indicates temperatures from a minimum of 35 degrees Celsius or 94 degrees Fahrenheit to a maximum of 42 degrees Celsius or 108 degrees Fahrenheit. Listen, precautions to be followed while using a clinical thermometer. The thermometer should be washed before and after use, preferably with an antiseptic solution. The thermometer should be washed before and after use, preferably with an antiseptic solution. Jerk the thermometer a few times to bring the level of the mercury down. Jerk the thermometer a few times to bring the level of the mercury down. Before use, the mercury level should be below 35 degrees centigrade or 94 degrees Fahrenheit. Before use, the mercury level should be below 35 degrees Celsius or 94 degrees Fahrenheit. Do not hold the thermometer by its bulb. Handle it with carefully. Do not hold the thermometer by its bulb. Keep the mercury level along your line of sight and then take the reading. Keep the mercury level along your line of sight and take the reading. Handle the thermometer with care. If it hits against some hard object, it may break. If it hits against some hard object, it may break. Do not place the thermometer in a hot flame or in the hot sun. Do not place the thermometer in a hot flame or in the hot sun. To know more details about clinical thermometer, see the link in below. Another important thermometer is laboratory thermometer. Laboratory thermometers are used to measure the temperature in school and other laboratories for scientific research. Laboratory thermometers are used to measure the temperature in school and other laboratories for scientific research. They are also used in the industry as they can measure temperatures higher than what clinical thermometers can record. Laboratory thermometers are also used in the industry as they can measure temperatures higher than what clinical thermometers can record. The stem and the bulb of a lab thermometer are longer when compared to that of a clinical thermometer. And there is no kink in the lab thermometer. There is no kink in the lab thermometer. A laboratory thermometer has only the Celsius scale ranging from minus 10 degree Celsius to 110 degree Celsius. A laboratory thermometer has only the Celsius scale ranging from minus 10 degree Celsius to 110 degree Celsius. Let's see precautions to be followed while using a laboratory thermometer. Do not tilt the thermometer while measuring the temperature. Place it upright. Do not tilt the thermometer while measuring the temperature. Place it upright. Note the reading only when the bulb has been surrounded by the substance from all sides. Note the reading only when the bulb has been surrounded by the substance from all sides. To know more details about laboratory thermometer, see the link in below. Do you know, students, in humans, the average internal temperature is 37 degree Celsius. In Fahrenheit, 98.6 degree Fahrenheit. In humans, the average internal temperature is 37 degree Celsius or otherwise 98.6 degree Fahrenheit. However, no person always has exactly the same temperature at every moment of the day. Temperature cycle regularly up and down through the day according to activities and external factors. Let's see the activity with laboratory thermometer. Now, we will measure the temperature of hot water and cold water. Keep the thermometer in cold water and hot water vertically. See the picture. Keep the thermometer in cold water and hot water vertically. Ensure to dip whole portion of bulb end. The bulb end should not touch the bottom or side of the beaker. The bulb end should not touch the bottom or side of the beaker. First, see the cold water beaker and observe the movement of rise of mercury. When it becomes stable, take the reading of the thermometer. Repeat this with the hot water and take the reading. Now, we are going to learn about difference between clinical and laboratory thermometer. First point, clinical thermometer is scaled from 35 degree Celsius to 42 degree Celsius or from 94 degree Fahrenheit to 108 degree Fahrenheit. Laboratory thermometer is generally scaled from minus 10 degree Celsius to 110 degree Celsius. Second point, mercury level does not fall on its own. In clinical thermometer, mercury level does not fall on its own as there is a kink near the bulb to prevent the fall of mercury level. In laboratory thermometer, mercury level falls on its own as no kink is present. in laboratory thermometer, mercury level falls on its own as no kink is present. Temperature can be read after removing the clinical thermometer from armpit or mouth. Temperature can be read after removing the clinical thermometer from armpit or mouth. Temperature is read while keeping the laboratory thermometer in the source of temperature. Example, a liquid or any other thing. Temperature is read while keeping the laboratory thermometer in the source of temperature. To lower the mercury level, jerks are given. In clinical thermometer, to lower the mercury level, jerks are given. In laboratory thermometer, no need to give jerk to lower the mercury level. No need to give jerk to lower the mercury level. Clinical thermometer is used for taking the body temperature. Clinical thermometer is used for taking the body temperature. Laboratory thermometer is used to take temperature in laboratory. Laboratory thermometer is used to take temperature in laboratory. Okay students, I hope you are understood about temperature units and types of thermometer. Now let's see some textbook pages related to today topics. Page number 1, lesson starts with learning objectives. Page number 2 explains about definition of temperature and its units. Tell me, what is temperature? The measurement of warmness or coldness of a substance is known as its temperature. Degree Celsius, Fahrenheit and Kelvin are the units of temperature. Then what is thermometer? Thermometer is the most common instrument to measure temperature. Thermometer is the most common instrument to measure temperature. Page number 3 explains about properties of mercury and alcohol. Also explains the types of thermometer. Commonly used thermometers are clinical and laboratory thermometers. Clinical thermometer used to measure the temperature of a human body at home, clinics and hospitals. Page number 4 given the details about precautions to be followed while using clinical thermometer and laboratory thermometer. What are the precautions to be followed while using a clinical thermometer? Thermometer should be washed before and after use, preferably with an antiseptic solution. Jerk the thermometer a few times to bring the level of mercury down. Do not hold the thermometer by its bulb. Handle the thermometer with care. Do not place the thermometer in a hot flame or in the hot sun. So what is laboratory thermometer? Laboratory thermometers are used to measure the temperature in school and other laboratories for scientific research. Page number 5 given the information of human body temperature and difference between clinical and laboratory thermometer. Yes, human body temperature is 37 degrees Celsius or 98.6 degrees Fahrenheit. Okay students, I hope you are all clear with the today's session. It's time for evaluation. Be ready students. Answer the following questions. First question, define temperature. Second question, write the units of temperature. Third question, what are the types of thermometer? Fourth question, the body temperature of Srinath is 99 degree Fahrenheit. Is he suffering from fever? If so, why? Fifth question, what is the use of kink in clinical thermometer? Okay students, first lesson heat and temperature. Part 2 is to be continued on next session. Thank you.